Hello, my friend. Welcome to TubeU China. I'm Henry. Recently, I modified my 3D printer to become a multifunctional CNC machine. Let's have a look. This is a time-lapse accessory I added a long time ago. It can be used as a time-lapse trigger very efficiently. Also, it is completely no interference with normal 3D printer function. I just connect it to my iPhone trigger when I use it. And this is what I call the exoskeleton box that I added recently. When you want to change 3D printer to be a multi-pane color 2D plotter, you can attach this accessory easily. If you want to use it as a drag knife, just change the pane holder to a drag knife holder. All of them are no interference with the normal 3D printer function. We see that this attachment already added a CNC function to the 3D printer. Can we use it as a PCB drill machine? Let's find out. I searched Amazon Japan to find a good PCB drill bit. I have found if you use a 0.1mm end mirror type drill, it is said the drill will easily be broken since it is too thin. Then, I changed the V-shape PCB engrave bit like this. I also have no experience, so I checked the comments as well. I think 0.1mm 10 degree knife may be easily broken. So, I finally choose the 0.2mm 20 degrees one for the test. After opening the case, I have found the knife is really sharp and looks very nice. Since the copper cover layer of the PCB board is very thin, it usually have a thickness less than 50 micrometer, say 0.05 millimeter, so the mini DC130 motor can do the job, I think. This motor can work as high as 12 volt, but usually about 5 volt is better. Make an attachment base and the cover to fix the motor. Use this normal shaft to fix the PCB bit to the motor shaft. I suppose you don't want to make the 3D printer circumstance become a mess. I make this simple PCB box to fix the PCB board and contain the cutting waste. Now everything is prepared. Let's test how it works. I made a simple test pattern using Illustrator. Export to the G-code file. Find the cutting and moving parameters. Modify the G-code file using Notepad++. I add about minus 0.1 mm height to cut the copper layer. Use very low speed to move the blade. I'm sorry that I forgot to switch on the motor power. This is the first time I make the PCB board. Oh, the motor speed is too fast that causes vibration since the blade is not symmetry. Decrease the output voltage to about 3 volt. Now it is stable. It looks not so bad for the first try. The resolution is quite nice. Also, I have made mistakes with the Illustrator G-code generation. Since the file is vector, so not use the imaging trace. The 50-degree line is treated as a parallel line. Some connection parts also have problems. Correct them all and try again. This time, it works very well. If you haven't seen the video here, please do me a favor. Click the subscribe button and a small bell so you will not miss my update. TubeU China is waiting for you.